The City of Pembroke Council has been working with the county on understanding the responsibilities of the new Algonquin Trail, which is a small section of the some 296 kilometers of the Ottawa Valley Recreation Trail, made up of the old CP corridor. At council, staff asked for support and signing a memorandum of understanding with the county in order to get funding under the OMCC, Ontario Municipal Commuter Cycling Program, to help with the refurbishment of the trail. Although the county is tailoring it to ATVs, snowmobiles, hikers, and tourists, the city wants to make it clear that they are not signing away the right to decide how or what can be used on the trail inside of city limits.
We still have control of the trail within our municipal boundaries. Is that correct?
It's correct. This particular agreement only has to do with the with the clearing of the trail for pedestrians, for cyclists. There will be further discussions regarding other uses.
Councillor Palafernie was stressing the bylaws in the city would be different from outside the boundaries of Pembroke, so that needs to be considered.
Some reason asking, is this going to be like four-wheelers trailing through and everybody? So there is some concerns within the city boundaries. If they're preparing it, that's great, but I hope they're not preparing it for certain users until they've been approved. That's right, because, I mean, they may get to the city boundary and then it's a different bylaw inside the boundaries.
The city and the county will be setting up meetings to finalize the agreement in the near future. The trail would join Smith Falls all the way up to well past Deep River, and it would go right through the heart of Pembroke. There are no timelines being given as to when this project will be completed, but it could be a big tourist opportunity for the city of Pembroke. Reporting for Cogeco News, I'm Trevor Riley.